What is going on, guys? Grave here. Welcome back to Marvel's Avengers. And yesterday we got our first ever kind of weekly war table blog from the developers. This is going to be something they do week in and week out to kind of talk about the new things that are being added into the game, you know, upcoming updates, marketplace changes, that kind of stuff. So let's go ahead and hop right into it. I will link all this down in the description if you'd like to read over it for yourself. It says priority missions have modifiers that will challenge even the toughest superhero. Your first weekly completion of these missions earns you unique gear you won't find anywhere else. And of course, it says this week the global presence, which is going to be lower power level modifiers, is going to be Blizzard, Capacitor, and Famine. Famine is where enemies do not drop regen packs. Capacitor is where shock damage from players is increased. And Blizzard, ice hazards are added to the environment. Cryo damage from enemies and the environment is increased. Now, if you are higher power level, you will see things like Rocket Red Glare, which has Famine and Capacitor in it, along with Pressure and Clash. Clash, melee damage from any source is greatly increased, and Pressure, no automatic recovery of willpower when critically injured. They said this week also, the priority harm challenges have additional modifiers and reward comics that increase your collection and boost your stats. The weekly first completion reward for this week's harm challenge will be 1962 Incredible Hulk number 105, and this is going to give you a 0.5 status resistance rate. Also, they talked about for lower power levels in this harm challenge this week, you will see things like Helix and Maelstrom. Helix's gamma damage from players is increased. Maelstrom, all heroics charge at a significantly increased rate. Entering critical health drains all of your heroic energy, so you want to make sure you're not at critical rate, or you're going to lose all of that fast charge that you just got on your skills and abilities. The next thing they talked about, of course, was high power level challenges in the harm room for, you know, higher power level players. You will see Famine, enemies do not drop regen packs, of course. Clash, melee damage from all sources is greatly increased. And Helix, once again, gamma damage from players is also increased. We talked about some different things, like tip-wise, that you could kind of be looking at or thinking of when you're facing all of this stuff. They said make sure that you're using the right characters, the right gear. So I said, for instance, if you see Blizzard as a modifier, equip any gear that provides cryo resistance. If you see Famine as a modifier, focus on takedowns, because that's the way you're going to be able to get your health regen back. Or, you know, some of the canisters that are kind of scattered across the map that actually give you health back, because there's going to be no other way to get your health back in game when Famine is active. It says Pressure, of course, recovering willpower by any means necessary is key when Pressure is active. It said when Clash is active, make sure to play a hero who has strong melee abilities. It says when Capacitor is active, it's going to definitely make Thor, if you're a Thor player, it's going to make Thor just a force to be reckoned with because of all the extra shock damage. It says if Helix is active, that's when Hulk will become a force to be reckoned with. And also it says if Maelstrom is active, keeping willpower high and utilizing heroics soon as they're ready to make sure you maximize the, you know, effectiveness of that fast, you know, regen of those abilities before you lose them taking critical damage. Also, they talked about the marketplace. They said they've added a few new things in, like Hulk's legendary tea time, emote Captain America's epic falling with style takedown, and Iron Man's very photogenic epic chroma luck suit. It says the marketplace, of course, is a place to purchase outfits, emotes, takedowns, nameplates, that kind of stuff, and they will be updating that weekly. Also, a few other things they talked about in this was, or kind of to finish out this whole blog that they posted, was the next update, version 1.3.0. So it will be their largest update yet and will resolve a lot of bug fixes, some bug issues, and hundreds of quality of life issues. So anytime we get any more information about that from from the dev team, I'll let you guys know. Hopefully they will give us kind of a time frame of when that update is going to be released. Anyway, guys, let me know your thoughts on this. And, of course, if you like the video, hit the like. If you have not subscribed yet, please do so. If you are a subscriber, make sure you click the bell icon in the top right corner so you know when all my videos go live. And if you have a chance to share the video, please do. It does help out the channel a lot. And be sure to check out everything down in the description, the community Discord, my Twitter, and, of course, the affiliate here on the channel, GT Racing. And I'll catch you all next time. Peace.